Good morning, children. Today we will do reading of the chapter The Priceless Slippers. So let's begin the chapter. As you can see the slide, he is Nizamuddin Aulia. The story revolves around him. So let's know him first, who he was. Sayyid Muhammad Nizamuddin Aulia was one of the most famous Sufi saints from the Indian subcontinent region, also known as Hazrat Nizamuddin and Mehboob-e-Ilahi, that is, beloved of God. He was born in Badun, Uttar Pradesh. He believed the love of God implied a love of humanity. So let's begin with the chapter now. The name of this chapter is The Priceless Slippers. Before you read, India is often referred to as the land of mystics. Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia was a Sufi saint who lived during the 13th century. This story shows his simplicity and the austerity of his lifestyle. It also shows how people with divine knowledge can give without having. Let's begin the chapter. In a little village, there lived a poor man who was so tired of being poor that his sole aim in life was to become rich and have a lot of money. In his desperation, he had tried many means of making money, but he didn't get any satisfactory results. Then one day someone told him of a great Sufi saint, Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, who lived in Delhi. The poor man was told that the saint was a very kind man with extremely wealthy followers. Surely he will give me enough money to start a new business, and then I will be a rich man, thought the villager to himself. The very next day, he set off for Delhi, where the Sufi saint stayed. He had to walk all the way, as he could not afford to travel on a horseback. Tired and hungry, the poor man arrived at the home of the saint at last. The Sufi greeted him kindly, and one of his followers guided him to where he could wash himself and brought him food to eat. After taking some rest, the villager told the Sufi the purpose of his visit. "Why is it so important for you to have money?" the Sufi asked. The villager recounted his woes. "I don't have enough money to even eat or clothe myself. If I have a lot of money, I will never have to worry about these things. I will be happy. You are welcome to stay here for as long as you want. You will never be hungry here and will always be decently attired," the Sufi assured him. But the villager was adamant. He wanted money. For him, that was the only solution to his problems. He wanted to continue living in his village, start a business, and live in a comfortable house. The Sufi asked him, "Why did you come to me? I am not a rich man, but there are many rich men in Delhi from whom you may go and ask for money." The man said that he had thought of that, but knew from experience that the rich were never eager to part with their wealth. I had heard that you never turn your back on anyone, so I came to you. The Sufi slowly nodded his head, but said nothing. He remained busy the rest of the day. There were prayers to be said, visitors to be met, and students to be taught. He continued his normal routine. The villager waited patiently for the Sufi to summon him and give him money or ask any of his wealthy friends to give him some. 2 days passed and he was getting impatient. On the third morning, he realized that his trip to Delhi was not going to bear fruit, and it was time for him to leave for his village. He had been taken care of very well. He had not been hungry, nor had he slept so comfortably in a long time. But money was not given to him. Feeling disappointed, he went to say farewell to the Sufi. "Are you leaving? But I can't let you go empty-handed." The villager's hopes were raised. The Sufi took off his worn-out slippers and gave them to the villager, saying, "You have a long and dusty journey ahead of you. These slippers may be useful. I only own what I wear, so I will give you these with my blessings." The villager was shocked, but did not show his surprise, as he respected the saint and did not want to insult him. The world talks of Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, but in reality, he's as poor as me, thought the villager to himself. He then left Delhi with a pair of slippers in his bundle. He was afraid that the people of his village would laugh at him when they would see or hear of the gift that the saint had given him. As the villager was walking in the hot sun, he saw a great cloud of dust coming towards him. As he watched, he saw a magnificent horse galloping towards him. An equally magnificent rider was seated on the horse. The horse and the horseman drew nearer and stopped in front of the villager. The striking horseman got off the horse and, pointing to the bundle, said, "You lucky man, are you coming from the great saint with a priceless gift?" The poor man stammered that it was indeed a gift that the saint had given him, but it was far from priceless. He wondered aloud how the stranger knew that the villager had been to meet the saint. "I recognize the sweet fragrance of my lord from the bundle that you carry." He introduced himself as Amir Khusro. The villager showed him the pair of slippers, and to his surprise, Amir Khusro picked them up reverently and held them to his head. "Be kind and give me these slippers for a bag of gold that I have earned for 6 months of work for the emperor. You can also have my horse and my robes." The villager was astounded, but he readily agreed to part with the slippers for the unequal amount. Both men were delighted with their exchange. Each thought that he had gained the greatest treasure. Amir Khusro left for Delhi and the poor villager returned a rich man. Never again in his life did he have to worry about his food or clothing, and he lived happily. Needless to say, he became a devout follower of the Sufi, whose humility he could never forget. Later, the poor villager came to know that Amir Khusro was a great musician and poet, as well as the most famous disciple of Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia. He wrote in Persian, Arabic and Hindi. He is considered to be the inventor of the tabla and the Hindi language. He was buried near the tomb of Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia in Delhi. About the story, Sayyid Muhammad Nizamuddin Aulia, 1238 to 1325, was also known as Hazrat Nizamuddin. He was one of the most famous Sufi saints of the Indian subcontinent. He stressed upon love as a means of attaining God, and his love for God implied the love of humanity. Thank you, children. I hope you all have enjoyed listening to the story as much as I did reading it. Read the story again. Thank you so much.